Richard Fowler's joining us again this morning, a Democratic political strategist. Great to see you, Richard. Good morning.
Morning. Good to see you too, Jamie.
Richard is joining us from D.C., and his website actually is richardafowler.com. People can check it out. I did. I went there after we spoke last time. And Flip Padeau is here, a strategist and president of American Civics Exchange, a real smarty. Good to see you, Flip. Thanks for coming in this morning. Appreciate it. Let me read to both of you. I got an email right before I left my office to come to the studio about a prediction about unemployment. We know that the president's jobs plan, the bill, is pretty much stalled for the moment. But this is interesting. Unemployment as measured by Gallup, without seasonal adjustment, whatever that means, is 8.3% in mid-October, and that's down from 8.7% at the end of September, 9.2% at the end of August. The reason I'm telling you this is it suggests that the drop, the government could then report an October unemployment rate of less than 9%. A lot of people have been waiting for this. So, Richard, does this come at the right time, if it comes, for the president?
Well, I think the jury's still out on that, Jamie, but I think you're right. It does come at the right time for the president, because the president has continued to show the distinction between him and the GOP in the House of Representatives by saying, you know, he's for jobs, he's for the working class, and he's for the middle class Americans, and the GOP just happens not to be, because they won't push portions of this Jobs Act. I mean, there's no question that there's parts of this Jobs Act that we, you know, probably disagree on, me and Flip, but there's definitely parts of this Jobs Act that we can agree on, like extending the payroll tax, or extending the payroll tax cuts, putting teachers back to work. I think those are the most important parts of the Jobs Act that we'll see the president push on his three-day jobs tour, where he will talk to some of those places that will benefit the most from that piece of legislation.
I'm not expressing an opinion, Flip, but they're calling it a jobs tour.
Mm-hmm.
But the bottom line is, when you look at the locations that the president has chosen to go to, and when you think about the amount of money that the president, the DNC and the president have spent close to $87 million in operating costs, this according to the New York Times, just since the beginning of the year.
Right.
Is it a campaign tour?
Yes. The jobs agenda is front and center on it, and so he's able to pin it to a policy matter to claim it's official business, but jobs obviously are number one issue to American voters too, and given as he's doing bus tours through key swing states, it pretty clearly is a campaign stop.
So how should the American voters feel about that, Flip?
About a campaign tour masquerading as a policy tour?
Or in combination with. Let's give it the benefit of
the
doubt.
Not particularly outraged, I don't think. It's a little disingenuous by the administration, but it's nothing I think people don't expect. There's some gray area between the policy and politicking in the best of circumstances. So, you know, it's a little cynical to be wrapping it in a policy flag, but I don't expect people will get too up in arms about it. But going back to the unemployment rate issue and the possibility of a drop, I would hope the administration isn't putting too much faith in the notion that they're going to see the headline rate drop on account of the Gallup data. For the real rate to fall, we need to be seeing actual job creation well over 100,000 a month.
And we haven't seen that
haven't
in
seen
how
that
long?
In years, really, in a consistent fashion. While the last month job numbers were better, they resulted in part from 45,000 striking telecom workers going back on the job. The only reason the unemployment rate hasn't drifted higher in terms of the headline is that people are continuing to remove themselves from those actively seeking work, so they're no longer counted. But every month that we're less than, say, 125,000, 150,000 real jobs created, the uptrend continues in that unemployment rate. In fact, as things eventually begin to improve, we may see it tick even higher as people on the sidelines then re-enter the job force. So I wouldn't.
If they're brave enough. Let's,